Hello guys, today we'll learn about phimosis, paraphimosis and circumcision. The questions which have been asked in previous examinations are a short note on phimosis, a short note on paraphimosis has also been asked, and there was a question which says write the indications of circumcision. So we'll briefly discuss these topics. Now this is a picture showing phimosis. In this, glans is not visible. The foreskin is, you can see, adhered anteriorly and it cannot be retracted. So this can lead to urinary obstruction, UTIs, urinary tract infection and various other problems. So the phimosis can be true or false. I have written only true phimosis. False phimosis occur in young children, 1 year up to 2 years, 3 years, you can say. In this, there is little adhesions between prepuce and the glands that usually does not require any treatment. A true phimosis is with scarring of the prepuce so that it will not retract without fissuring of the foreskin. But in children, it can be retracted. So in children, it is not requiring any treatment. So this can cause urinary tract infection, which leads to urinary tract infection. If a patient is having phimosis, then meatal stenosis can be unnoticed. So a diagnosis can be missed in a patient with phimosis. Okay, the questions which was asked is etiology of phimosis. The etiologies, the balanitis. What is balanitis? Inflammation of the glans penis. The posthysis is inflammation of the foreskin, that is prepuce. Then balanitis xerotica obliterans, it is also written as BXO. It is a condition in which the normally pliant foreskin becomes thickened, so it is not able to retract it. It is difficult to keep the penis clean. Why? Because obviously you can't retract, so you can't keep it clean. There may be recurrent attacks of balanitis, which lead to poor hygiene, which lead to increased susceptibility of carcinoma. So it is a risk factor for carcinoma penis also. Now, the treatment. Young child with a non-retractile foreskin, no treatment is required, as I told you. A term you can see in your belly and love is prepucioplasty. In this, the tightening of the foreskin, this is longitudinally incised and vertically sutured. So this lead to retraction of the prepuce and opening the glands. And in adults, the treatment is circumcision. Now the next topic is paraphimosis. You can imagine, if you forcefully retract the patient with a tight prepuce, it can lead to paraphimosis. This is retracted prepuce with edema. Okay, what is paraphimosis? Paraphimosis is a tight foreskin, once retracted, may be difficult to return. It is called as paraphimosis. When you will become intern and you put Foley's, you should retract back the prepuce. Otherwise, it can lead to paraphimosis. That is one of the common, you can say, methods or procedure that leads to paraphimosis. The paraphimosis leads to venous and lymphatic return. It should be decreased venous return. Leads to decreased venous return from the glans and distal foreskin, which leads to this leads to venous and lymphatic return from glans and distal foreskin. It means it increases, and which leads to swelling. Now The treatment is, in case of paraphimosis, ice bags can be applied that reduces the edema. Glycine can also be put. A gentle manual compression and injection of solution of hyaluronidase in normal saline can also relieve the condition. If it is not relieved, then this conservative management, a dorsal slit of the prepuce under the local anesthesia may be enough if the patient has presented to you in emergency. So what is dorsal slit? You retract and this you give a slit over here which reduces the edema and may treat temporarily. And if all the methods fail, the treatment is circumcision. So circumcision is not treatment for both phimosis and paraphimosis. Now we'll read about the question that is asked on circumcision. The indications for circumcision is, in infants and young boys, it is mostly, you can say social or religious reasons. You can correlate with the natural practice that is being done in some religions. The true phimosis is one indication. You should write true phimosis because in children, there can be false phimosis also. That does not require circumcision. The other indication is paraphimosis, BXO is balanitis erotica obliterans. If the patient is having recurrent attacks of balanoposthitis and recurrent UTI because of phimosis, it requires circumcision. In adults, usually sometimes there may be inability to retract the foreskin for intercourse. That may be one of the indications. Recently, evidence has shown, this is given in your Belly and Love. Recently, evidence has shown that circumcision protects against the spread of HIV. So, you can write one of the indications. This also. Now, the technique is, obviously, this can be done under local anesthesia in adult and in children, you require GA, obviously. After cleaning and draping, 1% lignocaine injected at the base of the penis, 1 dorsal and 2 lateral, all around. Okay, you can see, I have not added this slide. 1 is given here, 2 are given laterally. Now, the prepuce is held in the pairs of artery forceps and put on gentle traction. So, you can see this. These are held and put on gentle traction. The dorsal slit is made in the prepuce extending up to 5 millimeter of the corona. So this is incision being made. This is prepuce. It will stop at 5 millimeter proximal to the corona. Then a circumferential incision in penile skin is made at the level of corona using a knife or a scissor. So this is the circumferential incision removing the skin. After that, hemostasis is achieved. The frenular artery is very important. Here is the frenular artery. You can tie, you should tie obviously after the procedure, otherwise it bleeds very much. Now the skin edges are then sutured, and sutured uses catgut because we should use absorbable suture in this closure of skin, to skin margins. Thank you so much.